Good morning, students. I hope you all are fit and fine and you all have done your pending work also. You all have enjoyed your summer vacations and you all have done your activities very well. Keep it up, beta. Now we will move to the next topic, the verb and kinds of verb. What we have done till now, the noun, kinds of noun, possessive case of noun, genders, change the numbers, these are all are the topic of the grammar. Now we are moving to the next topic, that is called the verb and types of verb. Clear, beta? Just focus on this topic. This is a very easy topic. And whatever pending work you have, I suppose you have done till now. And do your work in a fair notebook and in a very neat and clean handwriting. Okay? And I am adding one more thing. I have added 5 words to improve your vocabulary. Please use these words in your routine life. First word is, beta, this is not the part of your syllabus. Only just use these words in your routine life. First word is pour, flow continuously. I am pouring the water from jug into the glass. That is called pour. The water is flowing continuously from one object into another. Next word is brisk, quickly. She is doing her work briskly or quickly. Now you can use these words in your routine life. Dusk, evening time. जिसे हम संध्या का time भी कहते हैं. Dawn, early morning time. Sly, clever. She is a clever girl. She is a sly girl. Okay. Now move to the topic. The verb, kinds of verb. What is verb? The action words or the doing words is called verbs. For example, what action am I performing now? I am teaching you. So teach is a verb. You are studying. So study is a verb. What action are you performing? That is called verb or doing words. Clear? So definition of word, a word that describes an action or subject says something about the subject. What subject is doing now? Who is subject? The doer of an action. Jo action ko karta hai, that is called subject. Whatever he does, that is called a verb. Clear, beta? That's why a verb is called doing words or a action words also. Now, we will discuss that, for example, Ram goes to Delhi. Here, what Ram do? Ram is going, Ram goes. So, go is a verb here. The sun is shining brightly. Shine is a verb and is a helping verb here. This is also a verb, but it is a helping verb. Clear, beta? Now, 2 types of verb are here. First is transitive verb and the next one is intransitive verb. Beta, transitive verb are the verb in which we require an object. Without object, that verb is not complete and the sentence doesn't make any sense. Okay, beta? That is called transitive verb. I will discuss the examples of the transitive verb. Intransitive verb, which doesn't require any object. Clear? Transitive requires an object. Intransitive, in means doesn't, not require an object. Okay? Wait for a minute. Now we will discuss examples of the transitive as well as the intransitive verb. Transitive verb. Here first example is the boy opened. As we know in transitive verb we need an object. Look at this sentence, the boy opened. Now the question arises, what does he open? Right? What did he open? Now we will specify the object here. The boy opened the door. In this sentence we need an object. No? So open is a transitive verb. Without object this sentence is not complete. Next example, the boy made. Here, made is a verb, but this sentence is not complete. What the boy did make? So, what we will do, we will specify an object. The boy made a kite. Now, this made is a transitive verb. Clear? Intransitive verb in which we doesn't need any object. For example, the girls dance. Dance is a verb here and dance is an intransitive verb here. Clear, beta? And we don't need any object here. Without object, this sentence is absolutely complete. So, dance is an intransitive verb. The sun shines. Shines is also an intransitive verb because here we don't need any object. Clear, beta? यू शुड रिमेंबर दिस पॉइंट्स बेटा. टेल मी वन थिंग, विदाउट वर्ब इज अ सेंटेंस इज कंप्लीट? नो, इट इज नॉट कंप्लीट. विदाउट ऑब्जेक्ट अ सेंटेंस इज कंप्लीट, बट विदाउट वर्ब इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल. अ सेंटेंस डजंट मेक अ सेंस. क्लियर बेटा? So you should remember these points in your mind. Beta, there are certain verbs which are transitive as well as intransitive. Kuch aisi verbs bhi hain jo dono hoti hain, which are of both type, transitive as well as intransitive. For example, the train stops. Here stop is a verb. And in this sentence, it is a transitive verb or intransitive verb. Here we are not using any object. If you are not using any object, then it is a intransitive verb and this sentence is a complete. We are using this stop verb in transitive form also. We will use object here, then the stop verb will become the type of the transitive verbs. Example, the driver stops the train. See, stops verb we have used in the intransitive form also. Now we are using this verb in transitive form also because we are using here the object. What does the driver stop? He stops the train. This is an object. Now stop is a transitive verb here. So this verb is are of both type. Next example, birds fly. We are not using any object here, so fly is an intransitive verb. And in next example, we are using fly with object. We fly what? Kite. Now fly becomes a transitive verb. Okay, one more example, the hunter shot. We are not specifying any object, so now shot is an intransitive verb. And in next example, we are using this shot verb with object also. Now shot is a transitive verb. We have used the same verb in both types, transitive as well as intransitive. Okay beta, revise this concept again. This is a very easy concept. Basically, to sum up the topic, transitive is a verb in which we require an object and intransitive in which we doesn't require an object. Okay, beta? So, complete the exercise of this chapter number 11. Okay? And then I will send you the solution. Try to solve it. Thank you so much, beta. Have a great day. Thank you.